The time has arrived, my sweet little squids. The hour is upon us for another motorcycle tier list video. Today we'll be diving into the controversial and much fought over gear manufacturers. When it comes to motorcycling as a lifestyle, few things are as contentious as the gear a rider picks. You might imagine that a motorcycle brand, style, or even engine configurations are the common fighting grounds for bikers, but in reality, we're incredibly vain pieces of work, and we always want to look like the cooler Power Ranger if you're into the sport bike thing, or we all want to look like the leather daddy we always knew we could be, or hell, we all want to be the next Ewan McGregor on our long way round in our adventure spec gear. Any way you slice it, we're extremely particular about gear. Now, as you watch this video, you'll notice we did not include many helmet manufacturers. This is because we're focusing on full line gear makers. Some brands like Arai, Shoei, or AGV are specialists in this category, as a brand like Seedy as well that only makes boots. While we could debate over and over about whether an Arai is better than a Shoei, let's be real, Arais are S tier helmets, this video is more focused on the full line makers. So these guys are going to be making things like your jackets, gloves, boots, and even riding pants. Now, before we jump in, I've gotta tell you about our motorcycle giveaway. It'd be irresponsible for me not to. We released the video last week where we revealed that we have a brand new Yamaha YZF R3 and Suzuki SV650 up for grabs. All you need to do is click the link on our Patreon to find out more how you can enter to win these bikes. So hit that link, learn more, sign up, and get started on winning these fantastic motorcycles. Now, without further ado, let's jump into these gear makers. We'll start off with our F tier brands. F tier gear brands are going to be those that you shouldn't touch with a 10 foot pole. They're the ones that will likely completely break apart in the event of a crash, and you definitely shouldn't trust them with your skin. It's not to say you need to drop all kinds of money on gear to make it good, but you should probably avoid these. Let's look. Built is one of those F-tier brands. Built gear is the kind of gear you buy when you have no idea what the hell kind of gear or you should get, or all you're doing is going to your local cycle gear and picking up a jacket, helmet, and gloves for under $300 out the door. Built is cycle gear's proprietary brand, typically manufactured in Pakistan or other faraway places, and that's not to say that everything that comes from international countries is junk, but you have to keep a close eye on quality when you're talking about something that's meant to save your life. It's gonna be your lowest of low-end gear, and you should probably avoid it at all costs. Sedici is going to be another F-tier brand for exactly the same reason. It's Cycle Gear's in-house brand, and it's going to be that same low-quality and low-end stuff you just shouldn't get. Think of it like a Big Mac. Yeah, it might fill you up for a little bit, but you have to question what went into that thing and why it only cost $3 to get to your mouth. Some of you might consider that a bit of snobbery, but there's a reason there's no professional racers wearing Built helmets. Moving on. Up next is our E-tier brands. These are going to be slightly better. Maybe you can get away with wearing them and someone might not notice, but they aren't going to be the most protective things in the market, and if you save up just a little more coin, you can get something really, really nice. Let's look. Gel Rocket is going to be an E-tier brand. One look at their website should be an indicator for you why we chose them as an E-tier brand, and while they are technically a full-line manufacturer, they're not really committed to making any meaningful innovations or updating their products. Primarily for Goldwing riders, apparently. Currently, Gel Rocket makes a motorcycle jacket you can technically wear on your body, and it might protect you from hazards on the street, but I would steer clear and spend your money in gear that had a lot more R&D put into it. Speed and Strength is going to be another E-tier brand, and you'll notice a trend in these brands that none of them are supporting or creating gears for racing teams, so they tend to be a little less R&D heavy, and through that, you the consumer gets a product that's just not as good. Speed and Strength does make some stylish street gear, however, many consumers report that the gear does fall apart and doesn't do its job. They also make helmets, and while they are ECE and DOT certified, the quality on the interior of the helmets and overall fit and finish means you could definitely do better, in my opinion. Now we move on to our D-tier brands. These are going to be moving up in spec, but they're still nowhere near the echelon of our high-tier brands. They might also have certain things that hold them back from being further up the chain. Let's take a look. Roland Sands is going to be D-tier. High price points and limited cross-style availability means that this premium maker is not competing in the same same sphere as the other guys, focusing a little too much on the cafe slash scrambler lifestyle branding, which, as a Ducati Biscotti scrambler boy myself now, I can't help but love. Roland Sands Design, or RSD, isn't quite the full line maker that some of the other manufacturers on our list are. We can't in good faith place them lower than this though, because Roland Sands is super high quality and pays lots of time and attention to the craft of making their gear. It just happens to be super limited in scope. AGV Sport is a D-tier brand as well, so this one's a bit complicated since you might have heard of the famous helmet brand AGV worn by Lord and Savior Valentino Rossi. The AGV Sport brand is actually an American company that brought the license to use AGV name in their own gear, so while they share the name, the two companies don't actually have a whole lot to do with each other. As such, a lot of the R&D from AGV is not shared with AGV Sport. It's extra confusing because in the 90s, AGV Helmets actually bought a 51% stake in the company, but then later in the 2000s, they recognized it as their own brand. Long story short, they're not the same. Despite supporting several racers, AGV Sport just doesn't carry a large variety of styles of gear. However, they are the suits that the California Superbike School uses, so that means they have to be pretty good. Let's place them as honorary C tier and move on. Now we get to our C tier brands. C tier gear makers are great in their own right, but similar to D tier, something holds them back from their full potential. Let's find out what that might be. Vanson Leathers is going to be a C tier brand. While the gear maker is absolutely legendary for their drag racing suits, even some famous actors have worn Vanson Leathers in their movies. Ricky Bobby from Talladega Nights wears a Vanson Leathers jacket, bet you didn't notice that. And the brand has had massive success in collaborating with streetwear brands. The company simply doesn't have the chops to compete with some of our high echelon brands. They make pretty niche products at pretty high price points, and they're just not worth it over some of these others in my opinion. Vanson Leathers, you might be pretty like Roland Sands, but you're too niche, you're a C tier, but you are legendary. Klim is also going to be placed in C tier. Although Klim is absolutely killer for the adventure and off-road market, that's about all they're really good at, to be honest. Klim makes some of the finest outdoor motorcycling equipment you can buy, however, to run with the big boys on our list today, you gotta come correct with all the ammunition you can bring. If you do rock some Klim gear, be sure to sound off in the comments below and tell me all about your rage and anger that we didn't include them in the upper tier of brands. I'll wait. Just kidding, I won't. I've got videos to make. Up next is our B-tier brands. Now we're really cooking. Our B-tier gear brands are going to be the ones that are very good. They're not exceptional, but if you were to get some of this gear, you're going to find that you're going to have a great time, get lots of looks, and not be an idiot who bought some F-tier junk. Let's look. Icon is a B-tier gear maker. With a full line of gear and even helmets as well, Icon has something for everyone. Icon has made a name for itself this past decade as the street rider's choice. They are known for pushing boundaries with their marketing and making gear that is as loud as the riders that wear it, in spirit anyways. With Icon, you're getting something that's gonna hold up well, is of good value, and will guarantee your safety in a crash on the street. Icon is vehement about promoting the street rider, as this excerpt from their website says. We stand alone in promoting the lifestyle of the street rider. Where others patently dismiss, we champion the cause. We will continue to push forth our street riding agenda, one avenue, one suburb, one highway at a time. This is an odd thing for a brand to own up to. It's like they're saying, yeah, we don't invest in racing technologies and we're proud of that. I'm not sure if that's the right way to go, but they seem to do very well. Either way, Icon is a brand that resonates with thousands of riders and they sell loads of products. I think you can do better as a street rider and certainly as a track day rider though. Now up next is our A-tier. A-tier gear brands are those that just aren't gonna let you down. Bred on track, off-road, and on the street, and everywhere in between, these brands are gonna protect you and keep you safe. They're not quite the S-tier brands, but they're pretty darn close. Let's look. Revit is most definitely A tier. A proud supporter of several MotoGP riders, a full line of gear selection, base layers, and any style you could want, Revit is a solid A tier brand. Revit is a company based out of the Netherlands and they started in 1995, which might make you think, wow, an A tier brand that's barely 20 years old? But it's true. Because of their significant investments in gear technology, over 10 years in MotoGP, and their commitment to making some of the best gear in the market, makes Revit an A-tier brand in my opinion. You might disagree with me that given that they're such a new company, but the only way to let me know is by sounding off in the comments, so go do that. Alpine Stars is also an A-tier brand in my opinion. Alpine Stars is no stranger to anyone with a pulse in the motorcycle community. Go to any weekend group ride and you'll be sure to see at least three folks with some Alpine Stars gears, and there's good reason for that. They've been supporting race programs for over 60 years, make a full line of gear for any kind of rider, and they innovated with an airbag systems in their gear as well. You just really can't go wrong with Alpine stuff. The company was founded in 1963 in the northern regions of Italy, and the quality was apparent from day one. Now, the only thing that keeps Alpine Stars from an S-tier brand is that they're just a little bit ugly when it comes to certain pieces of gear. So maybe that's my own bias, and maybe that's me being a little bit vain, but I do think that about Alpine Stars. Now, onto our S-tier brands. These are the god tier, the best of the best. S-tier brands will make you stand out, are the safest, most innovative, and offer a full line of all types of riders. Let's take a look. Dainese, to the surprise of no one, is an S-tier gear maker. With a full line of gear, the leader in airbag technology, and a massive supporter of MotoGP and racing programs all over the globe, Dainese is in a league of its own. Now, I know what you're thinking. Of course, this Ducati, Biscotti, Onan dude thinks Dainese is the best brand, but you'd be wrong to assume that of me. With several of the first of any kind, such as back protectors, knee sliders, and eventually airbag tech, Dainese's history is steeped in innovation. Also, did you know they made a skin suit for astronauts? How sick is that? Oh yeah, Rossi also wears Dainese, so there's that. I think that Dainese, given your tastes and preferences, could fall down to an A tier, and Alpine Stars could come up to an S tier. To be honest, I think they're kind of interchangeable, but for me, and in my opinion, I think Dainese is the S tier brand to go with. And finally, in a bit of a twist, as an honorary mention of one of the best kept secrets in motorcycling, is RS Tai Chi. You've probably not heard of this brand, but I consider them to be an absolute S tier maker in their own right. Although they make a limited product line, the attention to detail and quality is second to none. I recently picked up a full track suit from them earlier this year, and I've worn it to a couple days, and I've gotten plenty of comments from seasoned vets of how excellent the suit is, how they used to have one, etc. RS Tai Chi is from Japan, it's sold in limited stores, but definitely an S tier in my opinion. My suit anyways has so much articulation in the knee that it's kind of crazy to believe. It's an incredible, credible piece of kit. Now, the important part. What do you guys think? Did we get it right? Did we get it wrong? Let me know in the comments below. I always love hearing from you guys. Are you aware of any S-tier brands? Do you wear some Dainese, maybe some Alpine Stars? Let me know down below. And of course, make sure you sign up before July 4th to our Yamaha R3 and Suzuki SV650 giveaway so that you can get your double entries for the first episode and you get access to our Discord server and plenty of other cool perks. Check the link below and get started. Thanks again for watching. Tune in next time. I'll see you later.